Here comes the bride, all dressed in white. No, just kidding, because her soon-to-be husband's a piece of shit. Hear me out. So there I was, fully ready for my wedding day, as you can fucking see, when I received footage of my husband doing something he should not be doing with someone he should not be doing it with, aka not me. All I can do is laugh at this point. So obviously I freak the fuck out, right? And I'm like, what am I supposed to do? All these people are outside in this church waiting for me to get married, but now I don't want to get married. And if I'm being completely honest with myself, I sort of didn't even want to get married in the first place. If you think about it, this man sort of did me a favor. But anyway, this is when the story gets good, right? Because there I am in the dressing room wanting to die. But then who comes in? My best friend. My best friend comes to rescue me and he says, what do you want to do here? And obviously my first thought is, I want to leave. And let me tell you something about my best friend, okay? He always has my back. He has since I was a kid. We've been best friends forever. And so when I tell him I want to leave this wedding, what does he do? He helps me leave. We took Runaway Bride very seriously. Speak now, Taylor's version. This best friend of mine. Did I mention I've been in love with him since I was a kid? Did I mention I've been bottling my feelings up because I don't think he feels the same way? And I was supposed to get married and forget about all of this, but now here we are. And I'm supposed to take a road trip with him to help him because he's going through some stuff. And I clearly am not doing the best. How the fuck am I supposed to go on a road trip with this man that I have always loved, who just helped me run away from my wedding? I'm unsure. If you have any tips, please let the almost bride-to-be know. The almost bride-to-be is me, in case you're wondering. If that sounds interesting to you, and if you want to know what happens next, read Powerless by Elsie Silver. It's out now.
Here are 6 books written by Black authors that I will never stop recommending. A woman reluctantly travels back to her hometown where she learns that young Black girls have been going missing in the woods for years. This is an incredible debut thriller. 2 fathers with very little in common team up to avenge their son's murders. By far the most gut-wrenching yet action-packed thriller. It is next level. A second chance romance following a couple navigating life after divorce and loss. This book broke me into a million pieces and then put me back together. I cannot recommend it enough. A woman is repeatedly pulled back through time to face the horrors of American slavery, absolutely one of the most captivating and impactful books I have ever read. Set in a puritanical society, a young woman discovers she has dark powers within herself. This is fantasy and feminine rage, and I loved it. And a mother seeks to uncover what caused her son to take his life. This book has magic, mystery, deep-rooted family secrets. I was captivated by it.
A little context if you care to listen. I find myself in a shit position. The man that I love sat me down last night and he told me that it's over. Done decision. Am I? I might go honest. Not the best idea.
Lines are growing thin. I'm no longer sleeping in the shirt you met me in.
First time relaxing a book spine. Let's see if this works. I was barely able to open the book without cracking the spines. Let's see. Oh my. Whoa. It really worked. Look at that beautiful uncracked spine tip.
Hand me the black amount.
Me? Obsessed with you? Yes. Yes, I am, bitch.
Like, I don't know how people on BookTok are not talking about this book right now. Like, it's freaking phenomenal. Easily one of the best books I've read this year in terms of spice and plot together. It's so good!
I just remember thinking, this is so edgy and so different. People are not ready.
I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna be just fine. I'm just gonna be just fine.
BRB, about to escape and enter my magical fantasy world.
You're gonna lose it when I tell you that I'm a whore.
It's like a reward.
Okay. You got me there. But that is not a crime.
Get ready with me while I talk about unpopular book opinions. I love a good underrated, but I just feel like sometimes people can like love a book and it would just make my love for it seem less special. I don't know if that makes sense. This next one, I don't actually even know if it's that unpopular, but I feel like it needs to be said, and that is that going to the bookstore on your own is so much better than going with anybody else. I feel rushed when I go with other people. I feel like I can't read like the synopsis as like in depth. Like I just feel like there's so much pressure on me to just pick a book and get out of there. Okay, next, third person is sometimes better than first person. Actually, a lot of the time, because first person can get so annoying when you have someone's like in a monologue. It just feels more immature to me. And I feel like third person is a little bit more well-rounded. And I think you can convey just as much emotion and you can connect with the story just as easily if it is done well. I do fully understand that that's not always going to be the case. Okay, next is that I much prefer series to standalones or even interconnected standalones. You've got more time to fall in love with the story, the characters. It's just so much better, so much better. Okay, I also think that hardcover is better than paperback, and that is because the books are way more sturdy and they are so much easier to keep in good condition than a paperback, and I will die on that hill.
What is your favorite drink?
Water with a lemon slice.
What's your favorite food?
Water with a lime slice.
What's your guilty pleasure?
Water with a cucumber slice.
Favorite dessert?
Carrots.
Ew, you're telling me I have to train with that 6'5 hunk of tattooed man meat every day? Rain or shine, fire or earth, until we capture the bad guy? Ew, I just won't do it! No! Oh my god! And we have to live together? No! And shower together sometimes? Because there's not enough hot water? Oh my god! You're trying to kill me! I won't do it. I will do it. I can do it. I most can do it. I'll never do it. I'll always do it. Is there anyone else?
See, I was a victim too. But no one ever treated me like one.
Since you guys ate up the story of my fake engagement, I will finally tell you about the time I left my fiance at the altar. Honestly, leaving him was the least interesting part of this story, okay? The real tea begins the day after. My sister and I don't have the best relationship, but when she called me for an emergency, I dropped everything to help her. She lived in a small town in Virginia, but I literally still looked like a runaway bride when I got to this town and I was supposed to meet her at a cafe. But when I got to that cafe, she wasn't there. I'm so disheveled and caffeine deprived, so I order a coffee anyway. The barista's about to kick me out, and that's when I see my face plastered behind the register saying do not serve. I was like, oh my god, I swear that's not me, that's my twin sister. He didn't believe me, and I showed him my license and he's like, all right, you're good to go. He starts making me a fat latte, and that's when I hear the door open and I'm like, oh sweet, it's my sister. Nope, it wasn't. It was this big ass man, and he starts running towards me. He gets right up in my face and starts growling at me to get the fuck out, and I'm like, dude, I'm just trying to get a cup of joe. He was kind of sexy though, not gonna lie. Listen, I'm a people pleaser by default, okay? It takes a lot to upset me, but this man would not stop yelling at me, and I just had it. He clearly thought I was my evil sister, so I was like, listen, I don't care if you think I'm Tina, okay? I just had the worst day of my life and I'm having another horrible day, so just back the fuck off. Bless my new barista friend, he gives me my coffee and backs me up, and then I just get out of there because I'm like, I'm done. And just when this day couldn't get any worse, I go out and see that my car is fucking missing. Not only that, but I realized that my purse was still in my car, so now I don't have anywhere, like I don't know how to get around, so I'm freaking out. And that's when that guy comes back out and he like kind of half apologizes to me, is like, why are you freaking out? I tell him my situation. And he basically demands that I get in his truck and we'll just drive around, try to find my car. That is the last thing I want to do, but I really had no other choice. We drive around and start asking people if they saw anything, and they're like, yeah, we saw you get in your car. It wasn't me. It was my freaking sister Tina. At this point, I just break down. I'm so upset. And I just tell him to take me to my motel. And when we get to my motel, I see that my door is open. So now I'm not only upset, but I am absolutely terrified. He goes in with me. And that's when we see that my suitcase is ransacked. Like, the place is an absolute disaster. My laptop is stolen. There's shit written on the walls. It was a mess. And then I see the culprit laying on the bed, but it wasn't my sister. I'm about to lose it on this girl. And that's when they start chatting it up like they've known each other. I'm like, excuse me, you know, pint-sized criminals. He goes, yeah, Tina's daughter. I'm like, come again? The kid looks at me and she's like, you're my aunt? I thought you were dead. So here I am as a runaway bride. All my shit is stolen. And now there's a kid that I didn't even know existed. My niece, whose mom just abandoned her. And now I just have to like step up and be a guardian. But I wasn't just about to abandon her like my sister did. So I decided to step up and just start my life over in this town. What could possibly go wrong? I also may or may not have started falling for this man. Ugh. But if you want to know all the tea on that, then go read Things We Never Got Over by Lucy Score for the rest of the story. It is so good.